and today I am going to be showing you guys what I got for my 24th birthday. If you didn't know already, it was my birthday on January the 5th, and I am now 24 years of age. Yes, I am getting old. Not only am I going to show you what I got for my 24th birthday, but as you may know, our Disney store closed in Leicester and it was such a devastating day. If you want to find out how we reacted seeing it being closed, click on the previous video. I'll probably link it below, but we did a vlog on our trip to the Disney store on its last day of being open ever. I mean, it's been there my whole life. It's just so sad to see it go. But I've moved on from that. We're just gonna look forward, just keep going. I don't know where to begin. There's so many great things that I received, not only for Christmas, but now my birthday. I think my birthday being so close after Christmas, it's quite hard for people to find me presents, but I got the Lion King jumper. Tell you what, let me do this. Oh yeah. As you can see, it has Nala, Timon, Simba and Pumbaa on it, and it's in this beautiful rose gold kind of lettering, the Lion King. This was from Primark and I had my eye on it for a couple of weeks, but I didn't want to get it because I was just kind of like, no, you spent way too much this month, especially around Christmas. But I got it for my birthday and I'm so happy I have it and I didn't have to spend my money on it, but I'm so appreciative of it as well. I think it's become a tradition where I get something for my birthday that's from The Lion King, because The Lion King is my favourite Disney film and has been ever since I was 2. The birthday after it came out, I got the original Simba toy for my birthday, and it was probably to this day my best birthday present because I just love Simba and it's part of my life, and so is Disney. I do have to apologise if I suddenly do like a weird neck thing or something. My back of my neck, or should I say the top of my back, really has been hurting the past few days. I don't know whether it's my posture, because I do slouch a lot when I'm editing. We need to get that sorted, like, first. As you know, my dad normally buys me a surprise present either for our birthdays or for Christmas, and he tried really hard this year for my birthday, but he came in a couple of days after my birthday, because that's the thing. When my birthday is like really close to Christmas, it's really hard to get anything to come to our house quick enough, because my birthday is so early in the year. I don't know if that made any sense. He tried to surprise me and I honestly wasn't expecting this. If you know anything about Tahara Mafi's Shatami series, yeah, looks like this. Such a good series. There's 3 in the series, I believe. Oh, I still haven't read these 2, I think. I've read this one. The problem with this series, as you can see, is the first one's in paperback and the rest are in hardback. Now, you still can't to this day as far as I know, get the Shatami in hardback like this, with like a nice sleeve and hardback and everything, because the original Shatami was a different cover. It was like this girl on the front and that was the only hardback they ever released of the Shatami cover. However, my dad went to the lengths of trying to find me a hardback copy that fit in with the rest of my series, but he came to me the other day and he says, now I tried to surprise you, but again I failed. And I was like, what, you failed at now? Like, seriously, it's okay, whatever it is. Anyway, it's ever since that one Christmas where he got me the 2 Paramount jumpers, he's feeling so bad about it every year now. But he did manage to get me a hardback copy of Shatami, but the only difference is it's in this kind of like shiny cover and it doesn't quite match the rest of my series, as you can see. Like, it's the same height, I think, as the paperback. Yeah, I do like it. It's a lot more sturdy and I would totally feel much happy to take this around with me, like carry it around. But because I've read this one and I just feel like it's the same kind of texture as the rest of the series, I will probably be giving this away in a giveaway. Yes, I am going to be doing giveaways this year. I don't know when, but there will be a book giveaway and it will include this glossy, gorgeous hardback of Shatami by Tahara Mafi. I will include other things, I just don't know what yet. If you have any ideas of what you would want me to give away, please let me know in the comment section below.
So I want to treat you guys. I really do. I love you.
And I want to treat you. I did receive some birthday money. I'm not going to just flash my cash on the screen, but I'm going to show you what I did buy with some of it. So the week that it was my birthday, MAC released or launched a new collection in collaboration with Caitlyn Jenner. If you don't know who Caitlyn Jenner, it is the father of Kylie and just the Jenners. I was so intrigued by this range. I didn't go crazy on this range because I already had several things that were very similar product wise, but I really did want one of the lipsticks, and I got the lipstick in Rocket. It is this gorgeous mauve nude shade, I believe. MAC's packaging has been insane. I have loved the Mariah Carey range and their packaging. I have loved the Trolls range. Then there was the Star Trek range. Their packaging and their quality of the products have been amazing. So yes, Caitlyn Jenner, I got the lipstick in Rocket, and it's a cream sheen. And as you know, I love my cream sheens. It's kind of like a velvety matte kind of material, the bottom of this. It's not its normal hard plastic. But then you have a plastic gold lid with Caitlyn Jenner written on the top. And then we open it and it's this gorgeous, actually it's probably not mauve, no it is a little bit. It's this gorgeous nude, pinky, beige shade. I really like it. And this is the kind of shade that I absolutely love. Like in any form of lipstick, whether that's matte, a cream sheen, a velvet finish, or even a shimmer or a metallic, this kind of colour I absolutely love. It's like a nudie, pinkish, beige toned shade. It's kind of like what I'm wearing today. Then I went and picked up one of the eyeshadows. I was going to pick two up, but I still might pick another one up. I'm just not sure, but this one I really, really like the swatch of it online. It's only exclusive in some MAC stores, this collection, and it's online as well on MAC's website, so grab them while you can because they're not selling as fast as Mariah Carey, but they are selling quite quick. So the eyeshadow I got is called Malibu Bronze. Again, you have this kind of matte velvety packaging with the gold rim and Caitlyn Jenner's name on it. I love this. Fully bronze. I mean, look, you can see that. It might be a little bit more purpley in real life than what it's coming up on the camera, but it's a shimmer. I haven't used it yet and I'm not gonna swatch it now. I might just use it in a video, but it looks stunning. And with that lip, it would look beautiful. Because I ordered it online, I got two MAC testers. I got the MAC in Extreme Dimension 3D Black Lash. I have tried this and I don't really like this. I honestly don't. I think there's better mascaras out there. So I don't know, I'll continue using it and see how I go, but I don't think I like this. The other sample I got was the Prep and Prime. I love this. I tried it twice before my foundation and I wore it to work. I actually really like how this makes my skin look velvety soft before I put my foundation on, and it stays there. I mean, the foundation stays there normally anyway because I use moisturiser underneath, but I really like this. I can't remember who these are from, but I don't know whether this person picked these up from the Disney store or ordered them online, but oh my goodness. When I went to the store, they didn't have these in, so yeah, this is pretty cool. So I got some Disney socks. And the cool thing about these Disney socks is that one's Mickey and one's Minnie. I just think that these are so cute and so Instagrammable. I mean, I love posting Disney things. Me, I love having like odd socks, but match, if that makes sense. I love wearing the same socks, but I love when there's a set that comes together and they're different, but they're the same, if that makes sense. So you got Mickey and Minnie and it's the same colour and it's just, oh, I just love it. I just think it's so cute. The next Disney item I got from a friend at work was this Moana phone case. Now, I was going to pick this up when I went to London, but I didn't because I already have a phone case and I really love my phone case, but I really love this phone case. Not only is it silicone, it's Moana, and I absolutely have been loving Moana. I didn't want to go overboard on buying so much Moana stuff like I did with Frozen, but I did want some things that were to do with Moana, hence the Disney bag that I got when I went to London. My friend Aaliyah bought this in London when we went, and every time she had it on her phone, I kind of felt like, oh, I wish I got that now, but then I was like, no, I've already got a phone case, blah, blah, blah. But I'm really happy I do have this as a backup, so Yeah, I love this. I love the film. If you haven't seen it, you need to go see it. Seriously, you need to go see it. From my uncle and auntie, I got the Choice film, or the Choice DVD, on, or the Choice on DVD. That makes better sense. But if you love anything by Nicholas Sparks, I admittedly have not read any of Nicholas Sparks books to this day. I swear I said this last year, but I just haven't got around to it. But I love this film, and it's about two neighbours. One moves in and they are kind of irritated by each other, and then they fall in love. And I don't want to reveal too much else, but it's just a really good film. If you love things like The Notebook or Safe Haven, there we go. Safe Haven is one of my favourite, absolute favourite Nicholas Sparks books, films. I haven't read the book, I still need to read the book, but the film is so good. If you like The Notebook or Safe Haven, watch The Choice, because you're going to absolutely love it. I love it, I'm so glad I got it for my birthday, and yeah, can't wait to watch this. I might watch this evening, after this video. I don't think my birthday would be a birthday if I didn't get some Percy Pigs. I got the Veggie Percy, absolutely love these, and they're suitable for vegetarians. And then I got the Fizzy Pig Tails. The Fizzy Pig Tails were the first packet of Percy Pigs I ever tried. And I haven't had them in so long, but they are so, so good. So I love having a kind of, you know, non-fizzy and then fizzy. They're just gorgeous. And sometimes I think Veggie Percy is even better than the original Percy. But I love these. They are so addictive. I'm scared when I eat these I'm gonna want more. This has also been a tradition for the past 3 years, I think. This is the fourth year this has happened. But I have a gift card from my brother for the Apple iTunes store. I normally get this, and I asked him again to just, you know what, just get me another one, because I use it throughout the year. By December, I have like £1 left, because I use it wisely. So I have £15 on this gift card. I haven't actually put it on my account yet, because I don't normally use it until I know I'm going to buy something. It says, "To Katie, happy birthday from Christopher," which is my brother. So yeah. I think one of the best birthday presents I received this birthday was from a work friend. They did say that they were going to get me this. I just wasn't sure whether it was actually going to turn up. The post can be a pain sometimes. This is just absolutely freaking adorable, especially if you love Pokemon like my family do. Well, me, my brother and my sister do. As you may know, my favourite Pokemon is Bulbasaur. And this Bulbasaur is absolutely freaking adorable. I love him so much. And this is actually from the All Star Collection, Pocket Monsters. And I don't think I've seen a Bulbasaur this cute. It's just so adorable, and he can sit on my shoulder. Not sure he's gonna stay there the whole video, especially not near my candle. Wait for it. Look at it. I just love him. It's so cute. Seriously, thank you so much. You know who you are. And I absolutely love this. It's just gonna fall down me, yeah. But he's so, so soft as well. He feels like a Disney toy. Like, he looks like a Disney toy. That's how soft and cute he is. He's just so cute, and he will be going in my bed, probably next to my head, next to my pillows, because that's where I keep all my little soft, snuggly ones. And Bulbasaur is definitely one of my favorites. So yeah, I love him. It's so cute. The next thing was a pre-order that my dad got me. So it didn't arrive on my birthday. It arrived about a week after. But it is the Yumi at 6 Night People Deluxe Edition. But I think the only deluxe thing about it is the fact that it's a book and just a CD. Their previous album was a book format as well, and they actually released it with a print that was signed inside. So I love that. But this one's like signed on the front. It's actually all over the front. As you can see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 signatures. But this was actually, yeah, this was actually a deluxe edition. You had the whole first album, and then you had a disc too. But I won't really class this as a deluxe version. I don't know, it's only got 10 songs on it. And then, like, the book with the lyrics in. More books. The first book present I actually opened was The Chemist by Stephanie Meyer. I have not read a Stephanie Meyer book in what feels like forever. Especially a new one. She hasn't released a new one, so that's fair enough. And now I've got this one, which I really do want to read, because it's a whole new world, it's a whole new environment, and it's about an agent, I believe. So some kind of agent. She's on the run from the US government. I'm not entirely sure where else, but it sounds really good, right up my street. And it is about time I read Something New by Stephenie Meyer, because I really love her, the style of her writing and the way she creates her worlds and how they just seem to fit together so well. I know there was a massive hype over the Twilight series. I loved the Twilight series, but I think the fans, no offense, made it a little bit over the top and crazy. I love The Host. I so wish she would do a sequel or even a trilogy of The Host, but I'm so excited to read The Chemist by Stephenie Meyer. So yeah, I like that. I wanted that. It's another book that is ticked off my to buy list, and now it's going to be on my TBR list. The next two books I really, really needed and really, really wanted, because I love having the whole set of a series before I go into reading them. So I really wanted the sequel to Six of Crows. I still have not read Six of Crows, but I now have the sequel and the finale. This is the finale. It is a duology, and this is the final book in the series called Crooked Kingdom. And the series just looks so good. I really like the fact the first book has like black pages, and then this one has red. So yeah, they look so good together on my shelf. And you know, I love matching book covers. So this is not going to be a duology, it's going to be four books. So what's that, a quadology? This is the second book, and I still yet have to read the first one. However, the first book, which is called An Ember in the Ashes, is currently being filmed, I believe. It's going to be a film, and I really do want to get into this series before the film comes out. I love this cover. The first cover was so good. This just, oh, it just matches it. You have this really nice fiery gold spine, which says a torch against the night. And then these kind of two figures together running through a tunnel with this like snowy atmosphere with embers flying all over the place. But I really, really need to read this series. I have so many books to read, so little time. The next present was from my best friend, and I could not be more happier with this present, because I've wanted this for so long. And when she asked me what I wanted for my birthday, I said, right, well, I want a palette, a makeup palette, an eyeshadow palette, in fact. And she was like, just name it and I'll try and get it. So I was gonna go with the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, because I still don't have one. But then I found out that Anastasia Beverly Hills has a UK website, and I just had to ask my best friend to get me the Modern Renaissance palette. I cannot believe I have this. It's, the colours are just right on my street, and I'm just going to quickly show you. It's a bit like the Naked One. So the Naked One's very similar to this, the packaging. It's this velvety kind of material, and then you open it like this. These colours are freaking insane. Look at this orange, this burnt orange here. So good. And then you have like golds, and then there's like champagne shades. This shade looks really interesting, this golden ochre, this one here. It looks like a matte, but then there's not, it's not a matte, it's got like some shimmers in it. Venetian red. Oh, it just melts my heart. Seriously, this palette is going to be used like hell. Yes, thank you so much, Katie. This is just one of the best birthday presents you honestly have ever got me. You treated me well. Thank you so much. I love this. Can't tell you how much I love this. If you would like to hear my review and opinions on any of the products that I've mentioned in any of my previous videos, I will be happy to do one. Just let me know in the comments below which products, which range, which collection. I will do a makeup look, I will do a review, whatever you want. You guys are watching my videos, so yeah. And this palette is everything. So I had a lot of trouble with this particular present. It was sent to me, but then I was given the wrong tracking information. So even though I thought I missed my parcel, because they said they left me a card, there was no card. So I went online and asked them to re-deliver it a couple of days later. They re-delivered it, but not to my house. It was to someone else's house, and I had no idea where they even lived. It said it was signed under the name of Glover, so I was so confused. My mum was confused, even the postman was confused. So I did ring the post office, got it sorted, and they said that the company that it was sent by gave me the wrong tracking information. So I redirected to the company and asked them if they could send me a new one or what the situation was. They said it had gone back to their warehouse, which I was like, seriously, am I ever gonna get this present? I don't have a clue what it is. So, you know. So they sent me a new tracking information. The tracking information didn't work, but the parcel turned up 2 days after that. So I open it and I have this. I was not expecting this. I have a couple of eyeshadow pots from Ciat and I have a eye palette from Ciat. I knew this was released. I kept putting off buying it because I was just like, I don't need it. I have too many eyeshadows and lipsticks and everything, but I really, really wanted to try this. So when this turned up on my doorstep and I opened it and it said happy birthday, and I was like, you are kidding me. So if you do not know what this is the Ciat London Beauty Haul in collaboration with Chloe Morello. Now Chloe Morello is a YouTuber, you should go check her out. She is amazing at what she does. I will link her YouTube channel down below and I'll also link her video where she actually shows you what this looks like and she swatches all the shades for you and the lip products. I am wearing the eyeshadow and the lip product. I'm wearing the mascara. I'm wearing everything in this because you get a mascara, a lipstick. It's a lipstick, it's a matte lip. You get the eyeshadow palette, which is called Pretty Fun and Fearless, and then you get a limited edition makeup pouch to go with it. The colour scheme is absolutely gorgeous to this packaging. It's so beautiful. You have these rose gold flamingos, Chloe Morello's eyes, you have Chloe's face on the back. It just looks so good. I have an itch on my leg. I will show you what you get in it. For the swatches, go check out her video. That's Chloe Morello. She is amazing at what she does. And yeah, that's all I'm gonna say on that. Comes out like this. Some of the instructions have fallen out. It comes in this plastic packaging, and if I just take off the lid, you get a little note from Chloe. You get this cute little pouch, which I am gonna be taking on holiday. I love these kind of pouches. I put all my brushes in there, my makeup in there. And then you get the liquid matte lip in Pinup. Gorgeous, I have it on my lips today. I love it. The only thing with this, it has a really weird scent. It's kind of almost like a perfumey scent. Oh, slash soapy. It tastes a little bit like Lush. So it's not horrible. It's okay. It's not the greatest taste, but it's not horrible. And then we have the Ciat Wonder Wand Mascara. I have this on today. I am impressed with it. I really do like this. I'll have to see how I go with it because I don't really like the Too Faced. I know there's probably a load of people that are going to hate what I'm going to say now, but I don't really like the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. I'm not so keen on it. Maybe it's my mini ones that dry up so fast and I don't know, it just clogs up a little bit. And then the gorgeous palette. The depth of this is quite nice. It's really sleek and thin. And then you have Pretty, Fun and Fearless. And the writing is actually in silver, so that's nice. This is actually a sticker, this one, which it says curated by Chloe Morello. So if I open this, you get these gorgeous shades. The shades that I have on my eyes today: Unconditional, On Fire, Queen Bee, My Tribe, which I used to blend, Vacay, this gorgeous gold. I've got this kind of like on the inner corner of my eye, and then Fierce. This shade here is absolutely stunning. I love this one. But yeah, I'm so excited to use all of these shades. This with the Anastasia palette are just right on my street. I love golds, I love purples, I love vibrant, rich pinks, but then my orange, my burnt oranges and my warm oranges. Love, 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 love. The other thing good about this palette is that this actually folds all the way to the back, so you can move this around, and it's ideal, especially when you just want to hold it like that and you're just dabbing away doing your makeup. So happy with this, and I will totally be using this. If you want a makeup look with this whole kit, I'm happy to do that. I could recreate this one that I'm wearing today. More than happy. So the next and final present that I got, oh my gosh, like really got me a little bit emotional, because I never thought I would actually get my hands on this. You know I love Harry Potter, you know I love Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, and you know which direction this is heading in now. For Christmas, I received the Newt Scamander scarf and I received the Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them original screenplay. I did want to get some Funko Pops from the Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, but the only particular character I really wanted was the Thunderbird, which they have not released yet. I don't know whether they'll release it, because if they do, I will grab it like there's no tomorrow. But the one other Funko Pop I really did want was a Newt Scamander Funko Pop. Now, as far as I know, in total they have released 3 versions of Newt Scamander. They have released him with his suitcase, him with his egg, the little egg and his wand, and then the other one is him with the cute little green little creature. Oh, I can't remember, the bow and something. Oh, I can't remember, but it's just so cute. But the one I really wanted was the one with the suitcase, because it is number one and Harry Potter is number one. I just felt bad that if I didn't get Newt Scamander number one, especially with his scarf, and I have his scarf as well, so I really wanted this one. However, I found out that they only ever released the Newt Scamander number one as a special edition item for the summer convention in 2016, which when am I ever gonna be able to get to this convention? I have no idea, because I don't have a car or anything like that, or can fly across the world. I mean, I could have done, but not just for a Funko Pop. And I decided to look on Amazon, and I decided to look on eBay, and they were like, what, 50 odd quid? 70 quid for this one Funko Pop? Anyway, comes to my birthday and I get this package. I open it, full of styrofoam, and I have him. I cannot tell you like how much I love this Funko Pop. It's like my favourite. This is going to be seriously treasured. I love it so much. And I have this thing where if things aren't in perfect condition, I get really annoyed. But this is literally spot on perfect condition. The boxes, everything. I don't know how they got their hands on this, but I am unbelievably so grateful for this Funko Pop. I never thought I would say this. Years ago, I hated Funko Pops. Like, I thought, I really don't want to get into the craze. But I've only got into the small craze of the ones that I really want. Like, the characters I know I'll keep. I'm not just going to buy characters all over here just because they're in the same film or in the same TV series. But I really wanted Newt Scamander, especially since it's Eddie Redmayne as well, so because I love him. But he's just so adorable, his little flicky hair, and he's got his scarf and he's carrying his suitcase. I really wanted the one carrying his suitcase because it's just him. I just love it. I really do. I absolutely love this. I just love it. I'm so happy with it. Oh, I'm melting over a Funko Pop. Seriously, you need to grow up. So, as I've previously told you, and if you've watched our vlog that I've put up, the Disney vlog of it closing, our Disney store in Leicester has officially shut. I could not be more devastated. Like, I was so angry, so upset that it was closing, especially since my sister is never going to have that last experience of being in the store. But I am happy that she's seen it in full life, because on Saturday our experience was kind of heartbreaking to see all the shutters down on the walls where all the shelves were, and there was only that section in the middle that was actually covered in the sale merchandise. However, we're just going to get into what I got. They were giving out free Moana posters, and I didn't just pick one up, I picked two up. Yeah, so I have two. One for my sister and one for me, because I'm that kind of person. I have to get duplicates when my sister's away, because I know she'll want one for herself. I even had to buy the last Disney bag I will ever buy from our Leicester store. I just had to get it. I picked up, in this gorgeous little wrapping, this cute little plate. I already own the Stitch one of this. You might have seen that in another video. I need to take these stickers off. But it was only £1.47, and originally they are £2.95, so I thought, you know what, I've got the other one. I wanted one with Mickey and Minnie on, but there isn't one with Mickey and Minnie on. But you've got all of his little friends, and I have plenty of Minnie things, so you know. I love these plates. They're just the perfect cute size for putting your hair clips on, your necklaces on, or your earrings on that you wear constantly. And you just put that on your dressing table and it's just perfect to easily access those little things you want to wear that day. So yeah, I love that. They would look dead cute on little stands as well, which I probably will do that in the future. But yeah, £1.47, bargain. So the other thing I got was this cute little Zoom Zoom necklace. This was £4.39, down from £8.95. But it's just a cute little necklace and I could just wear it as my last day at Leicester Disney Store necklace. But it's got Mickey on a cone, on an ice cream cone, and then it has Minnie just above it. I just think it's a dead adorable, and for £4.39, why the heck not? Okay, last two things. One is from the Disney Store and the other isn't. Me and Katie were looking through the t-shirts in the Disney Store, and to this day, I don't think I've ever brought a Disney t-shirt, a Disney Store t-shirt, or even a Disney Parks t-shirt, because I was quite young when I went to Disneyland. But when they had my size in this top, I just could not get it, especially as my sister's away and it's kind of like a nice tribute to her not being here. So if anyone knows me or my sister, we love Frozen. Well, we love every kind of Disney film, but we love Frozen, and I really relate to Anna and my sister really relates to Elsa. I got myself an Elsa t-shirt. I absolutely love this. It's in a size small, it's V-neck, and it fits perfectly. That's one thing that's kind of annoying at the Disney Store. You cannot really try on the t-shirt, I don't think. I'm not sure. This was £10.90 something, or £10.80. I can't remember, but it was £10 something. The last thing I just had to get was from Primark, and it was the Moana t-shirt that they do in Primark. I have not seen any other merchandise for Moana the film, so I just had to get the only Moana t-shirt that they had in Primark. It was only £6, so you know, why the hell not? Just to let you know guys, this is a size 4, and so is this jumper. What is going on with Primark sizes? I can fit in 4s, 6s and 8s. I mean, that's great, because if they don't have a certain size in some things, I'll have it in another size if they've got it. But yeah, you've got Maui, you've got Pua, you've got... I forgot the hen's name. Oh my gosh. Oh, I had it then. Hey Hey. And then obviously Moana, and they're all like, blah, at you. I don't know what I just did there, but that's probably not as good an impression than they do it. Yeah, I love it, and it's just, it's really cute, simple and casual style t-shirt. So yeah, I think that is everything. There is one other present that I would show you, but I currently at this point don't know where I've put it. I was searching for it, but I couldn't find it. So I will include it in another video when the time comes, but it was basically just a makeup bag with this really nice quote on it, and yeah. That is everything. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to our channel and comment below. I love you guys and I will see you next video. Bye guys! Bye, 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 woo, bye, bye. Okay, now I'm singing the Hubba Hubba and Hoobland. Hoobers? I don't know what they're called. The week that it was my birthday, oh my goodness. Breathe. It is this gorgeous and the packaging's just gorgeous. Seriously, I cannot get, I need to breathe. If you love films like The Notebook, because that was based on one of Nicholas Sparks' books, I don't think my birthday would be a birthday if I didn't get... Oh, my eye. I've got something in my eye. Ugh. It was pretty much edible Christmas. I've got something in my eye. It's really irritating me. I think it's out. I'm not sure if it's out. It don't say. It used to say. What the flavour was.